The SQL team is always working on updates to SQL Server enabled by Azure Arc. Learn all about what's new and a little bit about what's coming, including copilots and security. This week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, we're going to be talking about some new and exciting things that have landed recently in Azure Arc for SQL Server. And to do that, I'm bringing on Dhananjay, also known as DJ Data. Welcome. It's been a long time since you've been on the show. Can you give us a little bit of a reminder about what you do?
Yeah. Hi, Anna. Good to see you. And thanks for featuring us on Data Exposed. It's great to be able to reach out to the community and talk to them about what's new. Hi, everyone. I'm Dhananjay Mahajan, or DJ Data, and I head the product management team here that's working on Azure Arc for SQL Server, Azure Arc for SQL Managed Instance, and Postgres. And today, I'm excited to talk to you. Since the last time we talked to you, Anna, there have been a host of changes that we have made and improvements that we have made to SQL Server enabled by Azure Arc that helps our customers get the best out of the cost and performance of their SQL databases and modernize them by Arc enabling them and connecting them to Azure. Many of our customers are moving by modernizing, by moving to PaaS using Azure SQL Managed Instance or Azure SQL DB. Some of them that can't change their applications are also using Azure SQL VM and then getting benefits of the Azure hybrid benefits. While those that have to stay outside of Azure, specifically on-premises or any other third-party clouds, they can take advantage of some of the new improvements we have made with extended security updates for SQL Server 2012 and now 2014, which is also coming up for extended security updates. And our enhancements are targeted to help you, our customers, accelerate the use of SQL Server and get the best cost and performance optimizations out of those approaches.
Awesome, cool. Yeah, it's no surprise that SQL Server enabled by Azure Arc has seen just huge growth and adoption. You know, a lot of customers see that end of support, or they want to take advantage of some of the capabilities you all are delivering, are super excited about this. So let's jump right into it. What's new?
Yeah, and you're absolutely right. We are responding to our customers so quickly that if we have not been talking to you for a long time, there are some cool new improvements that we have done with the intent of addressing your challenges. One is migration assessments. Now, the entire process of migration for our customers does take multiple steps, multiple stages, probably sometimes months. And they have been using one of our popular tools called Azure Migrate. Well, we have started the process of integrating the Azure Migrate engine into Arc, and you will see that in the latest release, you can get continuous actionable assessments of your Azure SQL real estate, so you can make the right sizing decisions and decide which of your SQL servers are ready to move to Azure SQL VM or Azure SQL Managed Instance. And this also gives you the best performance and cost, and it's a reporting that is done instantly, automatic, and on a continuous basis. Wow. So you don't have to start deploying tools, removing them. It's all integrated into Arc. And you can start looking at discovering your entire real estate, understanding, assessing it, and our tools, Arc, will analyze your SQL Server and give you reports that tell you which ones are ready to move to Azure SQL MI or Azure SQL VM. Number two, extended security updates. As many of you know, and many of you have been using extended security updates for 2012, now 2014 is coming up for renewals. And if you don't want to upgrade, I think the best way to do is you upgrade to Azure SQL DB or Azure SQL MI or Azure SQL VM. But if you cannot, because you either have a third-party tool or some other are the constraints of upgrading to the latest and greatest of SQL Server, whether it's SQL Server 2022 or the other ones that I mentioned, you can get your SQL Server 2014s ready for extended service updates. And this will extend and support availability for these SQL servers over the next years until you're ready to migrate them to Azure. And the important thing here to remember, Anna, is that all these charges are prorated. So the moment you move it to Azure, you're not losing any of your dollars because you're locked into like a 1 year or 2 year licensing deal. So really, really consider that. Some of our biggest customers have been starting to use Arc more heavily by using these extended services.
Yeah, I love that one, especially because it kind of have this pay-as-you-go type of model, if I understand it correctly.
Yeah.
So like when you're able to upgrade, you can immediately, you know, stop paying and move on.
Yeah, exactly. And that brings me to the improvements we have made to the pay-go model is physical core licensing. Now, physical core licensing is also available along with the ESUs. So with Arc, we introduced consumption-based billing, as you rightly pointed out, Anna, for your on-premises SQL servers. Well, now you can optimize it even further for using AVS, Azure VMware Service, or even on-premises. You can leverage unlimited virtualization benefit if you're running a lot of SQL Server VMs on a single set of physical core by adopting the physical core licensing. So not only is the PayGo becoming very popular, but we have also now introduced physical core licensing, which means you can run unlimited number of VMs running SQL Server. Of course, there's a trade-off, so you want to be watchful of packing too many VMs into the same physical core, but at least it gives you a cost saving if you're rightly packing your SQL servers that have medium to low utilization onto the same physical cores, and then you go with a physical core licensing model.
Awesome. Got it. That is some really big news across the board. I think customers are going to be really excited about it. You know, I have to ask, DJ Data, lots going on in the Copilot space. How's the SQL Server and Arc team thinking about Copilot? Anything people can start to get excited about there?
Oh, great question. Great question. I'm glad you reminded me about it. If you go to Microsoft Build, our very own Bob Ward, in Shirish Thota's keynote that's titled Power of AI and Copilot for Azure Databases has dropped in a hint about what's coming with Azure Arc. Imagine Azure Arc enabling your SQL servers and getting the power of AI to all your SQL servers out there. So as soon as you Arc enable the SQL Server, you can start using Azure Copilot with your SQL servers and get the best of the models we're building for Azure SQL, both as DBAs and developers. And the initial version of it, which we demonstrated at Microsoft Build, was more of the pre-preview version where you can get detailed inventory and understand your resource utilization, understand how the performance is going. But imagine this going even further and helping our developers, you know, write better code on your SQL servers. So more to come. Later on this year, we'll announce the preview date, and I want each one of you to try it out and give us feedback. But that's coming up awesome. Right around the corner now.
Cool. That's great to hear. We will be sure to find a link to that Build presentation. We'll put it in the description. So if you want to learn more, viewers, you can go learn more about the sneak peek. My last question for you, DJ Data, is, you know, security is really top of mind for Microsoft right now. And I was wondering if there's anything you all are investing in to help SQL Server people be more secure when they enable using Azure Arc.
Absolutely. Security is number one. Data protection and data security is number one for our customers. And so I and my team are heads down working around the clock, improving our security postures, improving the way you can deploy Azure Arc agent into your highly secure environments and giving the best security features for your SQL Server databases with Microsoft Defender and more services to come. But in the coming months or even in the weeks, you will see in the July and August release some really good improvements on security that we are doing so that you can have a even better security posture. And we constantly continue to strive to raise the bar on security. And that has been our top priority for the past months to go as well. So that's coming down the pipe.
Awesome. Cool. Well, thanks so much for coming on the show. Personally, I learned a lot. You guys are working on a ton of things. I know people are excited to see it. If you click the link down below, you'll go to the Arc Docs. So yeah. Check it out. That's where you can get the latest info, even more latest than this show. However, we do plan on having DJ Data on in the coming months to continue to keep us updated on everything going on here. If you like this episode, go ahead, give it a like, leave us a comment, and let us know what you think, which update you're most excited about. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.